today we're making jaffles, traditional South African jaffles, and you're gonna love it. If you've got family in South Africa, or even more, if you grew up in South Africa, at some point in your life, your grandmother, your mom, somebody made you some jaffles. Today we wanna share with you three different recipes that we really enjoy in the jaffle. There's so many recipes that you could follow. There's so much you can do with the jaffle. But today, we share three of our favorite ones with you. Firstly, we're gonna make a breakfast jaffle, a lunch or anytime jaffle, and then what about a beautiful dessert jaffle? That's what we're doing today. Let's get straight into it. Let me introduce you guys to all the ingredients we've got here today. We've got two cheeses, mozzarella, gouda. We've got some butter, an egg, biltong. By the way, if you guys want to know how to make your own biltong, we'll leave something in the screen here for you to go check it out later. We've got some marshmallows, peppermint marshmallows. You could use any, whatever you have available. And then one of our favorite ingredients is chocolate, milk chocolate to be exact. Strips of streaky bacon. And obviously you need some bread. We've got a white loaf here today. You can use any loaf that you like. These are pre-cut. It's definitely going to help you. Most importantly, guys, you're going to need this jaffle maker. They normally come in one. We have got three because we're doing three ways today. And also, you know, you always have to wait for that next jaffle. This just speeds up the process a little bit more. A little bit more. For you guys that's not aware, we've started a membership. We really appreciate you guys to go and check it out. Maybe support us that way. It's entirely up to you. You guys that can, we really appreciate it. You guys that can't, doesn't matter. We're still bringing you great content. And the guys that actually sign up, there's some extra perks. You might want to check that out. With that said, let's get on with this beautiful jaffle making that we're doing here today. Now, jaffle making is very straightforward and it goes across the board. Works with any type of ingredients that you'd like to put inside. Basically, it should be something that can melt or is ready cooked for that matter, as you're only gonna have it on the fire for about 4 minutes aside and it should be done. You could use the stovetop, you could even use the oven. Normally it's easiest on the stove or directly in the fire. Like, we like to play with fire, so we're gonna do ours on the fire outdoors today. Because our breakfast jaffle consists of bacon and egg to be exact, we're gonna make sure that our bacon is nicely crisp. We're gonna do it in a skillet. You don't have to add too much fat, as the bacon's got its own fat that's gonna render. We're gonna do it about 4 or 5 minutes aside. Basically, we're looking for a crispy consistency, as we want a crunchy component to this jaffle. Once you're happy that your bacon is nice and crisp, you're gonna take it off and let it cool off on the side. Then it's time to prepare the rest of the jaffles. Let's do that. Now that your bacon is ready and nice and crispy, first thing to do is to butter your bread. Now, these slices need to be buttered on the outside so that your cast iron jaffle maker is nicely buttered and these jaffles that you're making ultimately will not stick to the cast iron jaffle maker, because that will be a huge disaster. So let's go ahead and butter all our slices. This is going to give it a nice crust, really going to add to the flavor and the end product. We just put them like that, two pieces together, butter sides to each other, and then we do the rest. Once all our slices are buttered, it's time to set up our jaffles. You want to make sure that the buttered side of the slices of bread is pointing downwards, outwards, basically. There you go. You just want to push it, make an indentation there, crack an egg in there, some crispy bacon, break it so it's more or less the right size, get it in there. In this case, more is better. You don't need salt. The reason for that is we've got some bacon on here, it's already salty, but I'm going to add a little bit of pepper. Right, that's our breakfast jaffle taken care of. All we need to do is just close the cap. Second one's going to be our all-timer, lunch, dinner, anytime really. It's going to be biltong, one of our favorite ingredients. Same as before, a little bit of biltong, just press it in there. And then we're going to need some cheese, which we're quickly going to grate. If you put slices of cheese, you can go with less. The fact that we're grating, we're mixing two cheeses here today as well. We're going to go over the top, because remember, grated cheese needs to be compacted to give you the same amount. So we got some gouda in there, got some cheddar in there. Now it's time for our pulling agent, which is going to be our mozzarella. Once you think you have enough cheese, just go a little bit further, add a little bit more, and then we're good to go. There you go, nice beautiful heap. Then we need to close this cap off, butter facing outwards. There you go. Now for the last one, Co's favorite, the dessert jaffle. Now guys, you can just let your mind run. Over here, you can do whatever you want. We're going to use two ingredients. It's going to be a marshmallow and chocolate. Same as before, just push it in. See how much you can get stacked in there, because that's what it's about, isn't it? There you go. nice piece of chocolate. I think that's perfect. Close the jaffle, make sure the caps are on nicely. And then, guys, it's almost time to put these jaffles on the fire. You don't have to, but we like to just trim the edges. Comes off pretty easy. As kids, we used to fight about this. These little edges. Of course, you know you're gonna wait a long time for the jaffles. So in the meantime, you want something in your tummy, even if it's just buttered bread, because it's usually fresh bread. We've got three jaffles ready for the fire. Let's go put them on. You have to manage your fire. Ours is quite hot, so we have to be ready to turn it over at any moment. We're gonna give it a minute, turn it over, and so forth. We're just gonna carry on doing the same. The hotter the fire, the easier your bread or your jaffle is gonna burn. So you just wanna time it just right. We've learned that in this warm fire, 3-4 minutes aside is actually perfect. If you got your fire medium, then you could leave it for the whole 3 minutes aside and then turn it. That looks absolutely divine. Now guys, at this point, remember everything's nice and hot and warm. We had some marshmallows oozing out, so we hope we haven't lost all of them. So maybe a pro tip, if I can do one, make sure that you leave a little bit of the edge of that bread on the side that's sticking out. Just leave a little bit of that and that will help seal these beautiful jaffles. Right, let's have a look at these guys. Right, I think it's time to cut these babies open. Let's check what we have. Oh, look at that. Look at that chocolate. That's beautiful. Right, next ones. Breakfast jaffles, beautiful. Now guys, I like a soft egg. So obviously if you wanna do that, just make sure you take it off a little bit quicker. I would say 3 minutes aside. Let's do our very last one, our favorite one, biltong and cheese. Oh, look at that, look at that. I just wanna dig in here straight away. This is beautiful. Now guys, there you have it. That's how you make a jaffle on the open fire outdoors. Like I said before, you can do it in the kitchen. But let me not let you guys wait. Let me try one of these. I'm gonna try my favorite, the biltong and cheese, because that's an anytime snack. Cheers, boys and girls. Oh yeah. That's right there. Beautiful. I have to say cheers to you now. I need to dig in here. Guys, you know this is great. You need to try it out. Spice it up. Put some extra ingredients in there. And guys, as always, if you like what you're doing, like, share, subscribe, enable those notifications so you get notified as soon as we upload new video. Thanks for watching. We cannot do it without you. We'll see you on the next one.